This is one of the most incredible parts of Sacsayhuaman, and the one least explainable by the local guides. This stone here is at least 15 feet long, 5 to 6 feet wide, and 4 to 5 feet tall. The groove in it, along the whole length, is almost perfect. Like the old statement of, you can't fit a human hair in there. The rock this is made from is pink granite. This, which I didn't notice before, is older, and this is probably diorite. You can see that it also has been shaped. It seems similar to some of the stone that we've seen at other places, ones in Cusco, like at Kinko, where my guide, who is native, born and bred in Cusco, dates that site at 5,000 years, 3,000 BC.
Could the ancients of Cusco have built a massive complex to protect him from the synchrotron radiation and X-ray during the Squatterman manifestation? If the theory that all of Cusco was laid out to form a puma shape when seen from above is correct, then Sacsayhuaman was its head. The fortress has three distinct terraces which recede backwards on each other. The walls, each reaching a height of 18 meters, are laid out in a zigzag fashion, stretching over 540 meters so that each wall has up to 40 segments. Eyewitness Spanish accounts describe a large, circular, 4 or 5 story tower centrally placed within the fortress and its foundations, along with those for two others, can be seen today. The fortress was said to have had a capacity for at least 1,000 warriors, but it was rarely needed as the Inca did not suffer invasions from enemy states. Sacsayhuaman was designed as much more than a fortress. The complex included temples, notably one of the sun god Inti. Inti was the Incan god of the sun, the one whom shone brightest and considered all-powerful, but he was also a benevolent god and capable of great generosity. However, Inti could be angered and he would demonstrate his displeasure through solar eclipses, which necessitated sacrifice to win back the god's good favor. Incan rulers considered themselves direct descendants of Inti, just as the pharaohs of Egypt considered themselves God's incarnation. The fear of the god manifests from the squatter man, the one whom once shone brightest, the giver of life, the grower of crops, and manifested intro, the discrete phases in the squatter field. A confusion occurs and an assimilation of thought reaches us today for us to decipher. Inti was the sun, but probably not the sun of today. This was the light of the Golden Age and widely regarded to have possibly been the planet Saturn before a supernova event radiated in the solar system. Within the mountains, Earth people sought shelter, and in Cusco, they built Sacsayhuaman to protect them from these intense atmospheric disturbances. Inti was the sun, which in Incan mythology was created by the supreme Incan deity Viracocha from an island on Lake Titicaca. Although Viracocha was higher in status, he usually remained in the background of worldly affairs and allowed intermediaries such as Inti to actually govern the world. Inti was married to the goddess of the moon, Cuella. Neatly linking the gods to mankind, the first Incan leader and founder of the civilization, Mana Capac, was believed either to have been instructed by Inti or actually been his son, along with the other original Incan ancestors such as Mamacoya, who was also described as Inti's wife in some versions of the myth. completely reminiscent of the so-called Osiris myth of Egypt. And this means that these people saw something in the sky. Matching up these gods' stories provides eerie echoes of what was witnessed. In this way, the successive Incan rulers could claim divine lineage and emphasize their role as intermediaries between the gods and ordinary people. Manuk Capac even wore a sheet gold costume to impress the populace with his divine parentage. However, it was not until the ninth Incan ruler, Pachacuti, Incan Yupanque, that the cult of Inti really became established in the cultural practices of the Inca. With the expansion of the Incan Empire, sun worship was incorporated into the religions of the conquered peoples and used as an imperial propaganda that the Incan were the people with a divine right to rule. The masks of Inti were typically made of thinly beaten gold and also had the sun's rays bursting from the god's head in a design common in pre-Incan deity mask. These rays were typically cut in a dramatic zigzag fashion and sometimes ended in a small human face or figure. The most famous such mask was on display within the Coricancha temple at Cusco. But what do you guys think about this anyway? Comments below, and as always, thank you for watching.
Okay, we're now approaching the largest stones of the zigzag wall in Sacsayhuaman, and this will give you a sense of the scale, because these are two life-size human beings.
That one is negative. And this one is positive. Uh-huh. The positive across, mm-hmm. Negative the minus sign. Quarzo. In the middle is the quartz, no?
Uh-huh. Entonces la verdad.
The truth. La verdad.
Grupo Peter, baje.
La verdad. Entonces, antes nosotros, a las personas, ¿no? Hacíamos como la energía en el ombligo y en el cuerpo. Entonces, voy a hacer un cerro. Esto puede ser temprano.
Cuando no hay nadie que vigile, cuando no hay nadie.
Porque si no, cuando te ven,
todos van a quedar lo mismo. He said, like, in the past, what they used to do is touch that positive energy with the cuarzo. Belly, the belly button,
uh-huh.
Here, touching that area. Right now we can do that because we encircle this.
Yeah.
But if we came tomorrow early in the morning, we might be able to do that.